Hi, it's Mike Chen. Bringing people back from the dead may seem like something you'd only see in horror movies, and these attempts usually result in something less than holy. Remember this kid? But later this year, researchers from Bioquark, a company based in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, hope to do just that. Now, although their process does not involve any dark magic spells, vampire blood, or a pet cemetery, this study is still extremely controversial. Because, well, this isn't Final Fantasy, and bringing people back from the dead with a phoenix down type formula just isn't done. Basically, this trial will inject stem cells into the spinal cords of people who are declared brain dead, as well as deploy lasers and nerve stimulation techniques with the hopes of creating new neurons, and that these neurons will grow and connect to each other, thus restart the brain and bringing the patient back to life. The scientists working on this study believe the stem cells may be able to restart the brain up again based on their surrounding tissues, which is a process some lizards use to regrow a lost limb. And here's the thing, the definition of death has changed a lot over the years. Before, you're dead when your heart stops beating. But now in many countries, to be officially declared dead means there has to be a complete loss of brain function or brain dead. But according to Bioquark CEO Ira Pastor, brain death is not completely irreversible. He said, "This represents the first trial of its kind and another step towards the eventual reversal of death in our lifetime. To undertake such a complex initiative, we are combining biological regenerative medicine tools with other existing medical devices typically used for stimulation of the central nervous system in patients with other severe disorders of consciousness." And this is actually Bioquark's second attempt at launching the study. The first trial launched in Rudrapur, India in 2016, but it didn't get any patients, and the study was eventually shut down several months later. Now the company is set to begin a second trial in a new location, an unidentified country in Latin America. The new trial will attempt to enroll 20 patients who have been declared dead and only kept alive through life support. The patients will first receive an injection of stem cells harvested from their own blood. Then a peptide formula is injected into the spinal cord, which will hopefully create new neurons. Then lasers will be used to help stimulate these neurons to form connections. And during this time, the patients will be monitored with MRI scans to look for any signs of regeneration, especially in the lowest region of the brainstem, which is responsible for independent breathing and heartbeats. Now, this may all sound really good in theory, but there are a lot of problems. First of all, if a patient is technically dead, how will he or she actually give consent? Because I'm sure none of us would actually want to come back like the Night of the Living Dead, and most likely that wish was not formally declared while they were still alive. Also, like I mentioned earlier, this trial is really just all conjecture. No one is able to say for certain that it could actually work. According to an editorial written in 2016 by neurologist Dr. Arian Lewis and bioethicist Arthur Kaplan, they called this study borders on quackery, has no scientific foundation, and gave families a crude false hope for recovery. Dr. Charles Cox, a pediatric surgeon who has studied the same type of stem cells being used in this trial, also said, "It's not the absolute craziest thing I've ever heard, but I think the probability of that working is next to zero. I think someone reviving would technically be a miracle. I think the Pope would technically call that a miracle." But of course, Pastor thinks Bioquark's protocols will work. He said, "I give us a pretty good chance. I just think it's a matter of putting it all together and getting the right people in the right minds on it." Now, for me, I don't mind the fact that Bioquark is pushing the envelope. Just because there hasn't been a similar case of this actually working doesn't mean this new trial would not work. I mean, we gotta keep experimenting, keep trying. That's how we move forward. At the same time, I am hoping that they are not selling a lot of false hope. They're not making the families of these patients think that, okay, there's a good chance that this person's gonna wake up and be the same. Because I think with this trial, with this study, even if it does work, even if it brings the person who is technically dead back to life, I doubt that person would be 100% the same as he or she was before. Now, that aside, I do believe, and this is just my own opinion, but let me know your guys' thoughts. I think when someone dies, when someone is dead, something happens. And I believe that all living things have souls, so I think the soul actually leaves the body right away. Maybe it's something like that, maybe not, but something does happen as soon as we die. And death, of course, as tragic as it may be, is a part of life. And I know that we're all trying to live longer, we're trying to delay death, but when it actually happens, maybe we should just let it be. But let me know your thoughts on all this in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you later.